1972, the eyes of the world were on China, where President Richard Nixon boldly had its long-awaited premiere at the Met, and today we're presenting it to audiences all over the world. Russell Brown is the Chinese premier Zhou Enlai, and Richard Paul Fink is Dr. Henry Kissinger.
Thank you. It was smooth, I hope.
Oh, yes! Smooth!
Such a traveler, no, not I.
On this bare field outside Peking, the stars, the whole world was listening. History, 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 caught every jester. Transfixed, made history, history, as we the countryside looked drab and gray. Astronauts simply achieving. Who are our friends? buried with the bodies of our Lord. Dishes are washed and homework done. The dog and old cold warrior piloting towards an unknown shore. Earth murmuring down below. A friend of ours, the nation's heartland. Make good.
of this. He followed his career for generations. There's not much beneath. Books of mine are anything. Incorporate the word. In the neighborhood of Peking.
I'd like to make another trip as president.
You've got my... to fire him in that pigeonhole.
But Germany's another tale.
And Lily Song.
I spoke generally. Left.
Occasionally the true left calls a spade a spade. When good men raise it as their idol. While it is young in us, it lives. An organized oblivion. Let us not be misled.
Current trends suggest that China's future
might break the futures market.
You want to bring your boys back home.
What if we do?
You want to bring...
God.
Bread and wash us in our brother's blood.
After them come the Green Beret. The Golden Bowl.
The world to come has come.
The world to come has come.
We cried, long live the ancestors.
bide its time.
There you've got me. I'm lost.
We know the great.
Confucius, let him rot. No curse.
They are alike. It's food and
Platonic man.
Thou breaking the furrow, cloth pierced by the needle.
Another generation may. Tombs.
Past the fire and the noon glare, how they. Oh.
friends, fathers and sons, let us go.
The fact that hands are raised to strike, hands are stretched out to seize their
I'm growing old and soft.
Like you, I take my stand among poor people.
No.
Night is young, the night is young. Hey! for now. With me, wish we could send some to DC. You saw the moon in clouds and forecast snow. Go.
Meanwhile, we sit together in the court.
Edge of the Rubicon, men don't go fishing.
Call it over here.
Thank you. celebrate the different ways.
Think what we have undergone. That we survived those battles, took those compromising lines of thought. And see them still surround. We built these terraces for them. Occupy from all to all. Inheritance.
But never have I so enjoyed a dinner. Possible. No one who heard could. Out of touch. And had in court a single
call.
was China. I was wrong.
Find Nixon every time.
Well, you know, Nixon is such, there's so many layers to his character.
Right?
Yes.
Is it an exciting portrayal? Is it difficult to find Pat? Gestures,
yes,
and
but I do have an American husband.
Oh, I'm not trying to put you in another country. I'm just saying there's such. Both operas from John Adams. What do you find that's so rewarding about working with a living composer?
You're absolutely terrific. It's
thank
wonderful.
You so
Janice,
much. Thanks,
thank
John.
You.
Thanks,
John. Thank you, James.
Thank
all the best.
The really serious cold warrior, the anti-communist zealot, turns out to be the bridge to a new future. Has tension. It's not just abstract. It's actually incredibly vivid and alive and has all these, like, art. It has the comedy, it has the tenderness, it has the right. strangeness, it has the melancholy, right. but also some fun. Takes you to the Simón Bocanegra place,
exactly.
You know, where you've got all of that layering and color.
Okay,
Auden, yeah. She's moving yeah. through to Eliot, she's moving through to the great Chinese poets of the
time that you conceived this opera. What does it feel like to be here at the Met?
A blast. You know, layers of people doing work at the highest level. If you knew how deeply the costume and wig people care about every piece. There's been Tiananmen Square. There's been lots of history. And so, of course, I've changed the piece a lot. But
landmark China visit. We're going to speak with Winston Lord, former ambassador to China.
both your set.
Thank you.
What was so surprising at that time about a U.S. president visiting China?
For a minute, you look at the moonshot, Berlin Wall falling, and 9/11. I think Nixon's trip to China. I mean, Nixon earnestly trying to talk about issues,
yeah.
And Mao being very philosophic, and either being brilliantly.
So that was the main inspiration. I also looked at magazines from the time, specifically
right.
February 26.
Right.
At the first half was almost verbatim, and then it got more poetic, but it was in the same spirit.
A little more than a subject of late night TV comedian jokes. So my first response.
Did it cross your mind?
I think that I was so young and so green and so naive, I had no idea. Kind of way of talking where everything was very precise. And so there's a lot of staccato. He repeats
right.
himself.
Right.
Himself the leader of the people.
Kind of listening to himself a lot.
That's right.
Not getting on the tenor.
event, or, you know, weapons of mass destruction, or the president.
Is that part of the secret of... of Nixon in China.
In this world, you can't count on luck.
our secret.
She begs. She will get well. Some children having fun. From you.
be taken by surprise. Of liberty, change just a little. Let him be quick.
Ooh.
I was meant to come here. What a lovely party.
In the dust of their creation, communist.
Where is he bound? Naked and stunned, and over her he drags his skin.
I die, that luscious eye, that swelling breast. I started in, man upon.
to death, whip her to death, whip her to death.
You can't do that.
It's terrible!
I'd like to give his goddamn whip a crack.
Thank you. He stands like a stone wall, a stone.
The ringleaders' names, the gist of their schemes, loose chains.
You are what you choose. Your paradise begins and ends in open. Nothing. Give me that gun. Thank you.
Accomplishment, but also the greatest moment of pain as he is slowly dying from pancreatic.
How do you play this role? What do you find?
I think it's very seriously in the beginning and spend near the end.
Stay out of the way.
Exactly. Don't hurt them.
Right. Both of you, a question. How difficult presidents. What is it like working with John and Peter, John Adams and Peter Sellers?
Oh, one of the most positive
just becomes a part of you.
You get the last word of the aria. Yes. Just quick. What is it?
It's an insight.
What I tell them.
There isn't much that I can do, is there? his numbers.
All of us.
Hit it!
We die.
Come down, give me your hand. Tell me.
nakedness.
So much I couldn't. If they'd return all. But then I could not. Hell.
Such as...
meeting nothing like a word. I said goodbye to you then, Pat.
Did you?
time I should have died. And as we worked, on each rose from the base, just like a Roman sacrifice.
Never.
Thank you.
and nameless why.
An ancient tactical retreat.
After that,
a penny for your
the sweat had soaked my uniform. Friend, where several centipedes had drowned. not dislocated.
Go on! Interrupt!
As they advance, we melt away into the underworld.
You think of that, Karl Marx? Speak up!
I sure did. I had a system. Five cars.
I think you told me that.
They called it
Nicks, Snack Shack. I found the spell of
medium. Well done. Anything you say.
My way of saying thanks. When I put on thank you.
Before dawn, the birds begin the war.
Thank you.